Hello all and welcome to the first casting of C4 Diplo game. This isn't our first community game, but it is our first community game that's going to be casted, recorded, however you want to put it. It's going to be that. It's going to be epic, I can feel it. So I'm using the amazing Capture Age. I mean, Capture Age is brilliant. It is really, really good. All the interface, the bits and bobs you get with it, albeit not everything the pros have, so bear with me on that one. We are progressing slowly but surely, so you know, no moaning please. Anyway, moving on, I just want to quickly start by saying thank you to those watching, thank you to those that join the games, that are part of the server. It's absolutely brilliant. It really is, from the bottom of my heart. I love it. I've done this for you guys, for me as well, because I love these games. We all love these games. I think there's a certain somebody that we all know and love to watch and listen to, that has got us absolutely hooked on these kind of games. I mean, it's brought a whole new way of playing. I just used to play, you know, ranked 1-1s and team games, but this is just something else for me. The excitement, the adrenaline of playing, the nerves I get. Oh God, I'm nervous for these guys just watching, not even playing. Anyway, just wanted to give a thank you for that and let you know that is what we're here for. We're here for you guys, the community, bringing these games to more people like me as well, who are not very great at this game. I've got to admit, I've played a few Diplo games myself away from my community and it didn't go too well, to be honest. So yeah, that is the idea of all of this. This is for you guys. Anyway, moving on, I'm gonna start with blue, and the reason I'm starting with blue is because of the name. And yes, this is their real AoE name, so please don't ask me about it, because I don't think we've even got time to start trying to pick apart why he's called, you ready, or she, sorry, why he or she is called Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk. Maybe Elon's become a Lord Emperor. Maybe he's a techno. Maybe this is Elon Musk. Maybe. Who knows? We'll see if they bring out any Tesla cars. No, that's it. Don't say that. Okay, right. Anyway, Blue. Blue is new to our community. Actually, this is Blue's first community game with us. And oh, he's using his King Rail there. Maybe on accident. And Blue is playing as the Bohemians. I mean, no doubt we'll be seeing some not so noises later. Okay, Hoofness. And one thing I'll say is please forgive me on punctuation or any blunders. This is my first time of doing this, so it's quite exciting but nervy. However, probably not as nervy for some of these guys. Next we have one of my faves, Green. Now, first of all, I've got to say Green is very well known in our little community for being the best at hide and seek with a king. Green has gone a long time in a previous game with just a king. How they done it, I do not know, but they hid that king like it was life or death. Well, I suppose it was life or death on the game, but you know what I mean. The king was just unfindable. There's another one. The last game we played, I believe it was. Again, I feel so bad saying this, but I tried to snipe Green, even though Green was my fave. Thought the king was in a building with a flag, the only flag that had a building similar to this one here, but no, took the building out, no king ended up getting hidden behind some houses somewhere, not even by their base. So yeah, that's one thing to look out for with green. Giraffe is also playing as the Franks. Good cav, obviously. I mean, bit of stone around the gaff. Not too much stone around the gaff, so them cheaper castles might come into play. Who knows? Well, we'll see further on. Okay then, so who have we got next to Green? Next to Green in the grey? Call it grey? White? Grey? We'll go grey. Next to Green, we have Duck Duck. Now, Duck Duck again is another another one of our players you've had in the community for a while. Does some great things with a lot of differences. Brilliant Diplo player. So really, really, I'm looking forward to seeing how Duck goes about things. Like I say, this is the first time I've actually been able to cast a game, so I haven't got to see how people start, what their starts are like, and to begin with, I mean, picking Duck up here, but it's towards the bottom we've scored, but hey, it's early doors, let's see what we have a bit later on. I mean, Duck's playing as the Slav, so what, infantry? Cheap infantry? Maybe. Definitely one to watch, the Slavs on this map. And then, yeah, what else have we got over here? Okay, so next to green, we have got Old Crooked Woody, I believe that's how you pronounce it, in the orange. Again, I do believe this is Crook's first Diplo game with us. So, not sure actually how well green play. Orange plays Diplo games. So again, it'd be very intriguing to see how well he does. See what they do with the Incas, who, I gotta be honest, I've never used the Incas. Well, I do know one thing about Incas is cheaper infantry. And I mean, we have a quick look at the map. Look, I do believe this here is where we'll be a main focal point on the battle, so maybe the infantry will work quite well. Infantry spam, who knows? Anyway, that's all Crooked Woody in orange. Next to orange, then down the bottom, we have another one of our long serving members in Petrolhead in the purple. And Petrolhead is playing as the Berbers. Ooh, the Berbers. Used the Berbers a handful of times myself. Not a bad sieve at all. I'll tell you one thing about Petrolhead though. He will defend you to the death. That's one thing I've noticed in our community games with Petrolhead. If you ally them and you stay loyal to Petrolhead, they will defend you to the death. Even if they've got one soldier left, they will use that soldier to do whatever they can to help you. So great team player there in Petrolhead. So let's hope people ally him and use him for that. I know Petrolhead and Green Giraffe are pals outside of the game, so it'll be interesting to see whether they actually try and form an alliance across the map, or whether that friendship is going right out the window for this one. Okay, interesting. Okay, then next we have Red. Dr. Panda in the red. Oh, Dr. Panda. What a player. Dr. Panda is one of my favourites. One of my favourites to win this, actually, because the Diplo game, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And then there's Civ. Oh, the Spanish. That's got to be one of my favourites. I mean, unit selection is... You can choose whatever you want, really, can't you? I mean, you've got the paladins, you've got the halberdiers, you've got not the greatest archer line, but you do get skirmishers, the conquistadors, the shred people apart, and then the blacksmith, all fully upgradable, no gold cost. Yeah, I do think Dr. Panda's good here. And the one thing about Dr. Panda I've noticed as well is they will fortify their king beyond belief. It'll be very difficult to get anywhere near Dr. Panda's king. So let's see if he does that in this game. It'll be very interesting again to see. It's just all interesting, isn't it, really? I just can't wait for it to all start kicking off, to be honest. Anyway, let's move on. We have Teal. Pacific Nick West. Is it Teal? Oh, no. Apologise. It's Yellow and it's Domi. Oh, as the Chewitons again. Another person who has been with us for quite some time now, always trying to get into Diplo games. First of all, says he can't, then says he can. We all know he loves it. We all know he can. Just like try and play hard to get, I think. Anyway, Diplo games. Dummy. Dummy is the Chewitons. I mean, the resources. Again, it's going to be about trade here, because if he can get a big pile of those heroes in capes out, it will be a it'll be very difficult. Oh, what we got here? We're at some men at arms already. Is this a drush? Oh no, sorry, my apologies. Look, the game's gone so quick. They're all advanced already, but we're just scouting. What we're doing here anyway? Chiwetans, dummy, brilliant. Last but not least, light blue, teal. However you want to say it. Always say light blue, but I'm pretty sure it's teal. Teal, Pacific Nick West, is, I believe, this is their first if they're going. It might be their second divorce. But before the introductions are even over, it took me long enough, however, but it is kicking off already. Teal hasn't allied with anybody. Everybody's allied with Teal, I believe. Yeah, Teal is the only person, so maybe this is their first Diplo game ever anyway, who hasn't allied with anybody. Oh, now Red's kicking off with Teal. Oh, it's all going off. Dr. Panda with the Spanish already, look. Scout Cavalry. Teal's brought out the Spearman. That should scare away those, but the Men-at-Arms will take these... Take this out quickly, I believe. Oh, then again. Oh, what we got? The tower. The tower's out. Then minute. Spearman. That defends that, but that band already still down here doing damage to Teal's eco. Okay. Not the best start for Teal. I mean, you can wall yourself in now, but. It's bit too late for that. I think it would have been easier just to ally with everyone. No, well, you know, each to their own. Everyone's got their own way of doing things anyway. So that's the player's introductions. Let's have a quick scout around the gaff. So that's the map. Not the most amount of wood. I mean, there's a fair bit. About other resources, got a little smidgen of gold there. Smidge of gold there. So everyone seems to have a couple patches away from their base. But other than that, there's not a fat lot of resource at all. Actually, trade is going to be huge here. Trade is going to be massive. I mean, there's no water, so any naval advantages have gone out the window completely. However, as you can probably see, if I can try and... Can I... I'm trying to... Oh, here we go. 89 deer. Wow, plus some because of whatever's up there. So there's a lot of deer in the middle, basically. So if anyone's brave enough like this to venture out and get it, there's a lot of food out there. A hell of a lot of food. Right then, let's have a look at people's kings. So... there you go. Green's king. Not in the castle yet. I'm going to put a castle yet. No castles yet. I mean, a few people are in the castle, so I'm assuming we'll be getting castles going up very soon. I mean, purple's already for an eye. I ain't getting involved with no one, look. I'll block myself out of everyone. Brilliant. That panda's taking his time to wall himself in. Very trusting indeed, but he knows what he's doing. Oh, he's got the knights out now. Teal's under attack again. Oh, Red's still in there causing havoc. Absolute havoc. We've got a few spearmen that are spearmen. Have we got a spearman? We have indeed. We got a few of them there. They're not really doing much. Oh, I ain't working today, boss. It's a Sunday. And some of Teal's eco is going to take another knock. He's already quite far behind. He's still in feudal age. This isn't good for Teal. I mean, they've learned how to. They've either learned or decided to ally people, but not allied red, not allied yellow, the two attacking him, which is understandable, but send a little message, you know, hey buddy, I'm sorry.
Let's be friends. Because if not, the red does manage to get in. These knights will rip through a lot of this. A hell of a lot of this. Alright, some great early action. Right, let's have a look then. Let's have a look down here. We've got trade. Got some markets going up for blue. Brilliant. Look at blue's eco. Blue's going for it. Look at that. It's nearly 1,000 score above everybody else. And look at that. Look at that. It's 102 villagers for blue. I believe that's what it is. There's villagers there. I mean, the next closest one is in the 40s. Wow, blue has just absolutely gone for eco. 5 town centres. We're getting a castle up from blue. Wow. Oh no. Oh no, red has managed to get in. Red's got in with the siege. Teal's bringing out the spearman. It ain't gonna work. There he goes. 2 more hits. 1, 2, up, 3. Oh, and he's gone. Wow, Teal. And everyone else watching, listening, I think this is a word of warning. This is a word of warning to say, be friends. Be friends with everybody to begin with. Yeah, poor guy, exactly that. Ah, oh, if it was their first Diplo game with us, I'm sorry, Teal, but I think in future, be friends with everyone at the beginning. That's the idea. I think everybody in these Diplo games, everybody in Age of Empires, we're always looking for an excuse to kick right off, aren't we, really? Come on, we don't make an army just to look pretty. We make an army to kick off and crush some skulls. Now, if you're the excuse to get your skull crushed, people ain't going to think twice to do that. They will go for you. And I got to say, not allying people at the start is the best excuse anybody can have to crush your skull in. And that's exactly what's happened to Teal. So, word of warning. Make friends. At the beginning anyway. And then obviously a bit later on in the game, you kill everyone. These Diplo games, they're not easy. They're not the easiest games to play. It's diplomacy, it's diplomatic, it's Diplo, do you know what I mean? It's not just, oh, let's make some units and make a wall and kill people. That wall ain't going to do much for a bit. That wall's just a deterrent. That's not going to stop anybody's big chunky boys getting in, is it? And if they do get in, make sure you've got something to defend yourself. That is not enough. Anyway, that's enough on Teal, because they are gone. God rest Teal's soul. We'll have a vigil later. Let's have a look what else is happening then. So, yellow, king, town centre, yep. Another town centre, no castle from yellow yet. Red, king, tower. Yep, king in the tower. Red's got his little army ready, just in case. Love it. Purple, petrol head, king. King in the town centre. We do have a castle. I mean, I'm not sure how many people either recognise in the game because how full on it is at the beginning, or even know at all. The flag on the building indicates that a unit is garrisoned inside it now. When you've got one flag and one building, it's normally obvious to know that someone's king is in there. So the idea would be to get your king in the castle, it protects your king. Fires arrows, so it also defends the town centre. You know what I mean? It's the place for it, it's where kings are. It's king of the castle. And then potentially put in, I know people put villagers, a villager in other buildings, so that there's a flag on all of them. So unless you research treason, you won't know which one the king's in. I don't like putting a villager in there because it does me head in when I see idle villager. And it clicks to it on. Everyone that's getting paid to work shall be working. Okay, good stuff. Got trade going here. Who's trade?
What? Where's this trade going to coming from? Oh god. That was quick.
Red declared war on purple. Yellow must be
backing it as well. Okay, we'll check that back in a minute. What else have we got going on up here then? We've got Cooked Woody. King in the castle. Brilliant. We've got a relic. We've got Ducky. Duck, duck. There's their castle. King. King gonna move. King will move, no doubt. We've got trade going, yeah, so I've done. Ducky's on the gold. Green giraffe, still got the king in the castle. On the way to imp though as well. So far, wow. I mean, you close your eyes, you come off this for 2 seconds, and green's got 3 castles. Blue's got 3 castles. Blue's got still 5 town centres, but he's got 3 castles already. Oh, here we go. Oh, here we go. They've got in. They're in. Petrohead's not responding. Petrohead, respond. No, not doing anything anywhere else. Petrohead is responded. But he's still allies to everyone. So he's just... he's letting his units die, maybe? I don't know. Hello, nice to... Maybe? No. Oh, hello, nice to meet you. No, they're not your friends no more. Purple. Change. Town centres. Castles. They could all be killing units here. Change his stance. Oh, you got a unit out. But he's not going to do anything because he thinks they're all pals. Yeah. Brilliant. So you're just a tour guide to your village then. Come on, Purple. Change. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, purple castle coming down very quickly. Oh, the big boys are there. Uh-oh, where's the king? I can't find the king, where's the king? Where's the king? Got the king just in top. He still hasn't changed deep. Come on, purple, you need to change deep. You could have took a lot of these units out by now. And there it goes, run away, fat boy, run away. No, never. Dr. Panda's got his second king kill. I mean, it's a shame he sent it for some dollars because Dr. Panda will be rolling in it. Oh, that's such a shame. Petrolhead, that's such a shame. Oh, we've got 2 gone so quick. Brilliant. Right. See, that plan's not cool. I'll just slowly move my troops back. Yellow's took a ride in one of the big boys. Fair enough. Now, if I was red, maybe orange. The first thing I'll be, well, not the first thing, but one of the things I'll be trying to do pretty quickly. He's coming in and taking all these free resources. Have we got any more? Is that a bit of gold? Oh yes, I'll be coming in for that. Look at that, 2 patches of stone. 2.5 patches of gold. Brilliant. Well done, Red. Right then. Where else are we going? Let's go and have a look at Green's Graph. Come on then. Oh, ward themselves in. Brilliant. I've got to say, this is a pick for me. It's a bit of a pick, but I hate it when the trade flows through my old place. I just think, we're just going out the bloody way. Wow, the trade is really going for it now. Oh, look at that. 100 wood for 124 gold. Really? For 100 wood? What's duck wood? I mean, the gold's good, but I don't think I'd be trading. I don't know about you guys, but I'm sure somewhere there's some wood.
Yes.
Definitely wouldn't be trading gold for wood at this point in time. Unless they're trying to just bring the prices up. Oh, what we got here? I hope you don't intend to harm my innocent villagers. And who's that to? My gold? Where are we looking here? Oh. Look at this. Lord Emperor Elon... Oh, sorry. Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk. It's just four going off. I'll get a crafty bit of gold there. Hello, having none of it. You're like, no. I'll poke you with my sword if you can't take my gold. And I've built a castle just to make sure. Brilliant. Right. Let's have a look then. Wow. Elon is really getting on it. Building Gigafactory upon Gig. No, not Gigafactory, just barracks, but still good enough. Building many of them. I mean, he's got one unit. He's got one unit, and that's a monk. And he's just chilling. Other than that, he's all eco. But that's the joys of the diplomacy game. That is the joys. Because you think, in the normal game, boy, feudal, definitely castle age. You want an army, you want a military there, just in case you get attacked, or even to go and attack, do your thing. Some people like fasting, but again, they'll have walled themselves in, they'll have made sure, you know, they're untouchable. But in Diplo, as long as you use your words correctly to people, you can go, just like Blue, unprotected via military, for quite some time. I mean, we're 45 minutes into the game, and Blue's got one military unit, and he's just back here chilling. He is having the time of his life. Look at that, getting paid to do nothing. Brilliant. Anyway, where are we going from here then? Blue's everywhere. Let's take a look at next. Duck. Duck, yeah, brilliant. Alright, what have we got from Duck? Oh, Duck's getting his units ready as well. We've got Boyars. Elite Boyars. Brilliant. Elite Boyars. Look at that. Yeah, this much the Elite Boyars. Absolutely rip. But they're easily defendable. I say easily. Nothing's easily defendable. It depends on everyone's micro. That's one thing Duck I've noticed can be quite good at in water. Got his castles out. And he's got three castles here. Got another one there defending the gold and the TC and the trade. Brilliant. Let's go and have a look at the panda. Panda's getting his castles up now. He's got two there. That one's all he's got. Oh, look, he's done it. He's got on the gold. Oh, he's really got on the gold. Definitely want the gold. Gold from your trade. No one's expanded down here yet. What we got? Got a bit of gold. Bit of stone. Someone's os. Wow, look at that. Lots of wood for hardly any gold. Oh, it's so horrible, isn't it? Where else shall we have a look? Oh, we're getting a trade wall, I believe, or just this to near. Now, if you're red, and if you're potentially orange, you're thinking, great, if this wall goes up here, if that is what the plan is, then it just seems like we're picking sides. We're picking orange, red, and yellow versus grey, green, and blue. Now, blue and grey are two top scores. Don't mean a lot at the moment, but it is a slight indicator of how well they can play with Diplo games. But this does look like yellow is saying, I don't trust you this side. You're not my ally. Very interesting one from Dommy. Let's see what that will sound mean. It's just there. Maybe it's just a bit of a, you know, if you want to get into more dice, you go around. Ooh. Oh. Duck. As research trees in a lot of times. Okay. apologize for anything anytime soon. Techno God Lord Emperor Elon. Oh, he's so lovely. He's so lovely. How's everyone doing? Having fun, says Dr. Panda. One. Says Musk. What about you? One duck. But Duck's just said that to himself. Brilliant. So far so good from Green Giraffe. I am splendid, thank you for asking. Oh, look at that. He's a Diplo Dynamite. That's what we'll call him. Diplo Dynamite. Techno God, Lord Emperor Elon Musk. No. Way too long of a name. I mean, it's too long. Let's just call him Diplo Dynamite. That'll do. Petrolhead still getting attacked, bless him. He's clearing up all of purple stuff at the moment. Just a monk. A monk out and take over all these, maybe. Duck duck to blue. I think we have to hit yellow before trade war goes up. Ah, see what I'm saying? This is what I mean. Yeah, look, you've extended that, and now people are going to think, oh, you're blocking yourselves out from us. Like, you're excluding yourself from the group. Why? Oh, is that why? Has blue got a secret little friendship with yellow? Red, maybe? Because he wants this stone down here. Blue's not feeling that. Blue's thinking, I don't want to lose these guys. Oh, here we are. What have we got? We've got champions. We've got goats with capes. I don't think that's part of the army. We've got one dude there. Get your ass in line, boy. Brilliant. Okay. Oh, Blue's put himself all over the map. No wonder Blue's in the lead. Of score, anyway. By a long way, but it is just a score. That doesn't always necessarily mean you're going to win the game. I have Phil's behind Yellow's base. I could snipe, says Blue. Oh, he does. We've seen him. But will he? Will he? Not will he. Will he? God, my pronunciation. Don't apologize. Talk about willies. Duck duck one. So duck duck saying, yep, do it. Oh, we got a nice build up from green now. What we got? Halberdier. I mean, an elite for an X-Men. I've got to say, with the Franks, I never bring out these. Like, I know people have said they're brilliant, but I just don't bring out the throwing axe, man. It just doesn't. I think it's the sound. It doesn't sound very accurate to me. Dodger axe. Yeah, until it happens in real life and it sticks in the head. Anyway, yeah, with the Franks, I'm very surprised to not see an absolute buttload of stables, even back here, because they move quick enough to get up top. And that is the Franks. That is the Franks, isn't it? Cavalry. Stables, get them out, get the paladins out, and then I understand bringing Halberdier out. Definitely, there's one unit I love to bring out because it's a great counter to them. But what could be good as the Franks is to bring out your cavalry and then think, what are people gonna counter my cavalry with? More than likely, Halberdier. So, if that's the case, what counters their counter? Well, other infantry, maybe. Is that what counters a Halberdier? I'll bring out infantry or even onagers. Are the Franks, though? Are the Franks any good with archers? Because archers are a great counter to Halberdier as well. But even still, I'd be bringing out counters to my counter if I could. Don't seem to be any. I mean, there's a stable there. Is that it? Is that really it from green? Just one stable? That's very surprising. But let's see, they know better than me sometimes. What else have we got going on then? Gray's not really, I was going to say, not got much going, but he's expanded outwards a little bit. Little village there, that's so sweet. Red, only to you, says Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk, aka Diplo Dynamite. he thinking? Because him and Gray, do you copy? Him and Gray were looking on scheming against Yellow, but obviously Yellow is friends with Red. They took out two people together in Teal, Nick, and Petrolhead Purple. Is that long alliance going to be broken up because Lord Emperor Elon Musk, aka, oh sorry, Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk, aka Diplo Dynamite, has spoke. I do only to you, and it is. I like your name. And we are both doctors. Oh. Though yours better. Oh, sweet talk, sweet talk. Ain't gonna win your games, but well, to be fair, you might win your games. Look at these from Blue was out here wiping out the animals. You'll have Peter on to you at the end of this. Anyway, let's see what we've got going on. Yellow has got more goats in capes. Great. I love these guys. Bit slow, admitted, but you get enough of them together. The Teuton Knights, they do shred through things quite easily as well. Hot butter. Hot knife and butter come to mind. Okay, red, what we got? We've got paladins, we've got a few battering rams. Where are the battering rams then? They're here chilling. Oh, they're just taking out a wall. I wouldn't even do that. I'll just leave it there. You don't. It's a double protection, but it would mean since they're here the lowest. Oh, are they still talking about taking out your lawn? Must have missed that. Guys, some of you might need to keep an eye on the chat for me, because I've only got two eyes. Can't look at everything at once. Then let's go third from high to low. 7. I was thinking orange. Yeah. Okay, so I have to change their mind. Or are they thinking go yellow, then go orange?
Yes.
Orange is good. 1. Oh, is it orange is coming to get got? Who's getting got? Who knows? Gray's thinking, not me. I'm protecting my little self. Got some barracks. More barracks going up there from Gray. Could Grey be bringing out? Do we think, is he gonna go with just champions or what? Must be going champions. Go for Ela. Oh, no army. Oh, Green's looking on sniping Diplo Dynamite. Oh, Green's message to Grey. Go for blue, no army, and the right, 199 eco, and by the looks of it, someone or Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk has struck down the one military unit in the monk that he had. Your job is done, you may go. So Green is going to try and amass an army. They're now bringing out paladins. How many stables have they got now though? 2. Brilliant. Green, only to you. What do you guys want to do? What they want to do is murder you. Uzi said it to, is that green and yellow? Or grey? It must be grey. Hang on, I'm going blind. It's grey. Green and grey. Well, that's brilliant. Red? No, that's a lie. That's a lie. Green wants blue to go all the way down here, have a fight down here, and these two come round here and get him. I was thinking orange. Well, yeah, of course you don't want to go red because he's your buddy. Orange seems isolated. I mean, he's not wrong to a certain degree. He's not wrong. That's orange, 120. 80 units. What's Orange got then? Kamayuk. Oh, God, these lot are horrible. Oh, I need to do the unit texturing. Okay. I think so. I don't know, lol. I'm normally being attacked by now. Haha. Okay. So, Doc Elon Musk. 11. Doc Kingdom. Are you ready, Blues? Red to blue. Are you ready? Are you ready? No, is the answer to that. The deleting villagers now. I mean, let's have a look at the resources a quick sec. Holy smokes. We've got Techno God, Lord Emperor Elon Musk. He's as rich in this game as he is in real life. He's got, well, probably rich on this, actually. 49k gold. Gee whiz, where's he got that from? He just plucked it out of his arse. Lots of trade, brilliant. That's exactly what you want. And to be fair, look, he took over quite a few resources in other places which he depleted. Right, what's he building? What we got then? Uh-oh, we've got the not-so-hoofness. Definitely not so nice. We've got Helbs. And we've got hand cannon here, brilliant. I'm almost ready. Not quite. Then again, maybe so. Maybe so. Need to lay a few more villages than that. Ready when you are, says Green Giraffe to Blue. He just sent me res. Who? I feel bad. Oh, Orange. Yeah. Wow. Sent 1,000 food to Red. And pay 300 in taxes just to get taken out. Now, we ain't seen Orange for a little bit, but gee whiz. 14 barracks. It's not a fat lot, but it's enough. I don't think Orange has got a chance of surviving this against all four players. Unless.
Yes.
Crayon Green. Do actually. Go for blue, bro, blue. Blue says one. Two. Red, green, and grey. Oh, Cook Woody sent 500 wood to damage. Oh, no. Could you please chop wood not near my King Duck Panda? Holy smoke. See, this is what happened. Miss a lot that's happening. When did this happen? Yellow is red, sorry. I knew it. Yes. I know it would happen, though. He's red, red, red. There he is. See? That boy's there. You'd get him in there, wouldn't you? He'll be in there, don't you worry. Ah, there, look. Okay. Thanks, love, bro. Ron, love you. He said it to maybe an accident, maybe not, but he said it to a few. Duck, tell me when. Love heart to just blur. Oh, bless him. Well, Blue's still trying to get his army together. He's only got 65 units at the moment. Maybe that's all he needs. I think they must know that. Going for the Incas, they'll probably go with some sort of infantry unit. Where's Yellow's King then? I just seen it on volunteer. On garrison voluntarily, but God knows. There you go. King's there. I said, didn't I? Fortification beyond belief. I mean, yeah, I would have got castle in there, anything. Put stables in there, but I suppose that's good enough. How do you see this shaking out? Blue says to Orange, Yellow, and Green. Well, I see someone getting absolutely demolished in a minute, and by the sounds of it, it's about to be Orange. Bless them. They ain't got much food. They ain't got much resources at all, which might be due to the fact that they've got 77 halbs, 33 arbs, and 56 of these big pokey boys all ready to come out. So they're already paid for, I believe. No one's responding to Techno Godlord and Pretty Long Ross, aka Diplo Dynamite. That name might change over the course of the game. I ain't gonna remember that. Sorry, guys. Anyway, look what we got here. Blue's got his little army together. Wow. Answer me, brother Orange. And he said that. Blue said that to Green, Yellow, and Orange. Missing out Red though. I don't know why he's missing out Red. Is that accident or is he not? Is he planning? Woody, hello. Woody, you need to speak. It's Diplo. People are just gonna. People are not gonna be happy with that. I'm not gonna go for it. Oh, Green's King's on the move. Yeah, midst of war is not the time to be going for a jog. Probably going back there, aren't we? You've got 3 minutes to answer me, Orange. I don't take kindly to friends not replying to me on Diplomat. Says Blue. Says Diplo Dynamite. Techno Godlord, Emperor Elon Musk. Wow, Green's King gone back there. Orange, I'd reply. Because doing this just shows that you're there, you're playing, but I ain't responding to you. I respond to who I want. Go Orage. Red's raging. Okay. Let's ride together. Says Orange to everybody. 11, sorry. What's Orange doing then? Is Orange going for? Are they? The Diplo, they're still allied with everybody. Where is he going? Wow, look at the size of those pokes. Oh, this is not going to be good for Orange. Oh, it's happened. Orange hasn't declared war back yet. Oh, that's such a shame. Orange didn't even get a chance to change his stance before Blue absolutely obliterated him, losing a handful of units, if that. Wow, that's a shame. Reds took out whatever was there. Blue. Since you decided to not respond to me. Oh, wow. Oh, and Ducky declared war as well. Oh, Orange is getting it from all angles. Absolutely all angles. This is not going to be enough. Oh, you got no gold either. Oh, no. Orange. Uh-oh. Reds come with the tall stone slingers. Orange needs to use that. Not that it would have made a big difference to the outcome of this battle, but it would have been a bit satisfying to see if it was going to there is his king. Orange's king is. There he is. No, it's not. Orange's fat boy is. There he is. Oh, goodness gracious. No, I'm not going to be Orange now. And this is the thing, because it's not exploding things. You can't really do much with your king. You can't threaten anybody with it. You can't run into their base and say, you kill me, you take my stuff, and I'll run around your village with my king. It's not really going to have the same effect as I'll blow the whole shit up. The Orange has just got to ride this out and troll his best. I mean, look, the numbers have dropped for how many are huge. Oh, the gold. He's got gold. Not enough. I mean, these lot are going to absolutely shred the life out of these. Bits of building in it as well. Buildings for fun. I mean, canoes will do decent against the paladins, but I just think there's just two. I mean, look at these. It's not so nice. They're just going to. Oh, that's not fair. It's all good fun. Is his king still in there? His king is not in there. Where's his king? Oh, there he is. Uh-oh. Run away. Oh. Oh, he got away. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, the castle. Gray's castle. Absolutely guardian. Brilliant. I don't even think anyone knew where he was gone. Look, they're all still trying to think. Oh, he's dead. That's it. He's gone. Good game. It was unfortunate they weren't quite as talkative on the Diplo. Otherwise, they might have done a little more, a bit more expansion as well. Kind of hook yourself onto someone else's base. A bit like yellow. Hook yourself onto red's base, look. And you're kind of forcing an alliance there, aren't you? You're also potentially stopping yourself, allowing them to just come and take whatever they wanted to. Oh, whoa, whoa. Green's declared war. Oh no, look, it's going up. Green and yellow both declared war on blue. Blue's all the way over here, doing not a fat lot anymore. I think grey's declared on blue. He hasn't, he might do in a minute. Oh, this is not good for blue. We need to get some units out and start doing some at ASAP. I still think a group of paladins coming back here and taking all this out would be a massive loss for blue, a massive loss. Blue's building to the top green, we've got the trebs. I see again though. The thing is, yeah, it's good to get rid of all this because that's the army, that's where the army coming out, but we don't need to get rid of a few minutes, 2 minutes. Slowly but surely. Oh wait, what? Oh, with grey. Grey's attacking green and yellow. Grey's turned on green. Grey and green were scheming against blue earlier and now grey's turned on him. Or her. Wiping out the goats and goats. Not good. That's not good for yellow anyway. I mean, grey ain't gonna survive. Doing some decent damage. And then blue's still chilling. Oh god, no, someone broke through the wall, grey. Grey's got through green's wall. Oh my god, how am I meant to keep up with all this? Orange is out, so we won't think about that. We've got red's attacking grey. Okay, let's try and make heads and tails with this. Red's attacking grey. Grey's attacking green. Green's attacking blue. Blue is attacking most people. Yellow and grey are still having it off over here. But grey's also trying to fight over here. Green's now pulled out paladins to help defend the base. The attack on blue has absolutely died at the second hurdle. I say they got past the first, that was good, but that's all that's happened. Yellow's king's now under attack from blue. Blue's turned on yellow. Yellow wasn't helping him, yellow was trying to kill him. Is yellow king actually in here? So it is. Uh-oh. Got a hoof not so nice, he's getting your king. There's the king. Oh, this spells the end for yellow to me. Uh-oh. Run away. Oh, he knows exactly where he is. And good game, Chewitons. Good game. Dommy. Blue's taking his first king kill. Oh, meanwhile, yellow's still there. Yellow's still going for it. See, these goats in coats are brilliant. Brilliant. Okay, where's Blue's King? Blue's King's in that castle there. But that's not the castle they're hitting, is it? What are they hitting? I don't even know what they're hitting, but they ain't going to be hitting it for much longer, I'll tell you that much. Oh, look, Tommy had his little army there ready to go in. Blue's not going to keep these trebs. Green's not going to keep these trebs. What's happening in Green's base? Oh, they've defended. Everything's still back there, isn't it? Slightly protected, I mean, not massively, because the blue comes around the back, buff, done. We've got grey getting green, green coming back to grey, the paladins and foliage, we've got red attacks, and we've been short and green, and we've been short and green, and we've been short and I don't see why green and grey have gone against each other. It don't make sense. If you've got red and blue, you should be fighting together to get the evil. Why is it? Green and grey are fighting together. And red's just taking all the pickings. Like, yep, easy peasy. And grey is buying more wood. There's lots of wood about the game. That's grey's wood saying anymore, very hot. Yeah, it's got good resources at the moment. We've got a lot from blue. A lot. Castle getting attacked in the front center. Oh no, the hoof's not so nice in the hand cannons are here. Uh oh, green! Defend the king!
Yes.
Don't please break the mark, bro. Red says to blue. I won't. Mark it, maybe?
Yes.
Maybe? I don't know. 1v1 the matter. Oh, 1v1 after the final. Okay, so red and blue planning to take everyone out and go for a 1v1 themselves. Brilliant. Meanwhile, red and grey have together destroyed green. Green's. I think green's biggest mistake is going for blue, but not going direct for the king. You give him way too much time to get back into it, and then not making the paladins as well. I would have went all out palliers, a bit like red, except the 20%, I think it is it 20% for the front for the bloodline, 20% hit point, sorry, for cavalry. I mean, that doesn't mean added 20 hit points like bloodlines, that means 20% on top of what you are, what you've got. So when you get to paladins, that's more than the 20 that everyone else gets if you have bloodlines. That's a good, it's a good little advantage. You have to take advantage of it. And green's king is in this castle now, maybe. Yeah, there you go. Green king in the castle. Also got paladin in the castle. Okay, each their own. What's happened here? Oh, I thought Red's army had been destroyed. No, it's just pulled it back and having a restart. Oh, they're producing unit upon unit here. Uh-oh, the hoof not so nice are coming in. King's moved, king's on the move. See, I did think they'd hide the king. Not normal, not green normally does, but at this point in time. King's on the move. Oh my god, what a risky move. Who's green allied with? No one. And they've ran their king across, literally across the centre of the map. You can't get any more centre than that. And they've ran their king straight across the middle, allied with no one. Brilliant. Oh, Red didn't see it. I thought Red might have saw it. Oh, no. Let's see if we can see Red's point of view. Oh, you sneaky sneak. See, I told ya. What did I say at the start? Green is known for hiding their king. Look at that. Yellow flags. So you think, where's green's king? Oh, wow. See now. Green has really got no eco left. Green's a bit screwed here, aren't they? Meanwhile, it is going off between Grey and Red. GBs, it is going off. The Boyars have taken out. Oh no. I'll see what's happening. So, Red, I'm assuming, set a rally point for all these stables over here. And the units, when being made, are running to that point. And only when they get to that point are they trying to fight. So before that point, it's easy pickings for Grey. And Grey's coming in with the elite Boyars here. Over there, sneaking around the back. Oh, they've been found out by who? Who's found them out? Oh, Blue's found out. Blue's found out about the king. Oh, they just managed to get through with the king. Oh, no. But they're about to run into a big fat fight over here. Uh-oh. 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 Oh. They ain't gonna get out of this. Oh, no. And you're done. Another king kill from Dr. Panda. Well done, Doctor. I did say it in normal. I did say Dr. Panda's good. Dr. Panda is good. However, at the moment, Depot Dynamite, Techno God Lord Emperor Elon Musk, is at the top of the leaderboard. They're doing well, they're coming in with a hoof not so nice, and they're doing extremely well. They're taking out the yellow stuff, but the yellow's been dead for a while. Do you know what? I think Diplo Dynamite was the exact man needed for Blue, because look at this. What can Blue do? Blue can decide to get involved, picks a team, but then if that team, you know, dies, you used a lot of resources then to try and defend the team that was always destined to die, so you kind of don't want to do that. And even if they don't die, even if they're the team Red or Blue, Red or Grey, that means you're still using a lot of resources. But what Blue's doing is like, look, I'm busy, that's why I can't help. I'm busy still taking out Yellow, even though Yellow is dead. You guys are going to have to fight it out betwixt yourselves, so yeah. Never. While all that's happening, what is Blue up to? 39 in there. And Green's base just, yeah, I'll help. Bruh. Soz. I freaking knew it. Soz. Hold shift build. Not sure on that, but okay. Grey's just ultra spamming Boyars. For what purpose though? Because look at this, a similar situation to what Red was doing, just bringing them down here for them to get killed one by one from the Poke Boys. I'm not being funny, but you're not going to get through all these Poke Boys with those elite Boyars. They're really, really not. The best off either trying to come around the back, which you could easily do ish. Trying to get through that wall there. Then you're in, but you're not in because look, his king is back in there now, so I think fighting against Red is a bit of a waste of time here. A waste of resources, definitely. What's he got? He's got a lot of food, but that is it. All Grey has got is food. Handful of gold. I've seen more gold at the end of a rainbow. Jeez, ain't they doing much with that? Meanwhile, Blue. Oh, Blue. Blue's been taken out by the ghost of Dummy. Is it Dummy in yellow? It was. Wow. Oh, wow. Bet you're wounded on that one. Oh, what a shot. Just one last one before you die. Brilliant. Uh-oh. And the boys they don't try to attack. They might be a bit too far away. Help! Seven.
Oh, blue. It needs help. Help him.
Blue help, says grey.
You are both asking for my help, blue says to everybody. I have only one option.
Well, what's that then?
We're all waiting in anticipation. We have trade. Oh, Duffy's trying to plead.
Well, we have trade. Your body is.
Is that just a blue? What option? Come on, blue. Because we're all intrigued now. We all want to know. I must flip a coin. Oh, wow. Pain with people's lives and emotions from a flip of a coin. I defended you from yellow, says grey to blue. And red just thinks it's funny. Love? Lolo? I'm assuming LOL. Love? Maybe? Who knows? Red just thought. Red also helped me against orange and yellow. That's true. Merit. Yeah, exactly. You both have merit. There we go. Green red building begins to take out. Or what? Siege? Wiping red buildings out. Red's just sitting there thinking, blue, please help. I think the thing is, either way, blue helps either one of them. It's going to be difficult to beat blue.
I think blue's best option here, though.
Surely to help grey with red, because that is difficult king to get to. Okay. Strange, but okay. But yeah, if blue helps grey, try and get into that. Might make it easier for them both.
My army, dummy's still here watching. Oh yeah, he's bored in and out.
Sorry, that was just that's the soundtrack to this firing squad. This is absolutely brutal. Brutal beyond belief, blue. Like I said earlier, playing with people's emotions. Oh.
Oh, blue. Oh, blue.
Poor dummy. And there they go. Back to the battle.
Is there a battle?
Oh, no, they're both just building up at the moment. You can feel the anticipation in the air. The first move. Who's going for who? Who's blue going to help more? So has he flipped that coin yet? Gee whiz, how much time does he need to flip a coin? I suppose that's our cashless society these days. He's going to have to flip a credit card.
Did it land on the front side with the words or the back side with the stripe?
Either way, he's there ready. He's there ready and waiting to get involved. Hussars now from grey. Yeah, grey's gold is really up there. Blue's is. I mean, look at blue's resources. Red's not too bad. Not too bad, but blue's resources is just ridiculous. It can be very difficult to stop blue. I mean, they've got 79 villagers, but then again, red's got 145 villagers. Oh my god. Okay, red. I flipped a coin and you won. Uh-oh. Does that mean now that blue is turning go-go, bro? Will help kill grey go-go? Oh, he's going to turn on him. Is he going to do it? Dr. Panda's market is under attack from... What? Oh, from the grey.
Those are old
from yellow. Those are old from yellow? Okay. Brilliant. I got a feeling it's about to go off. Doesn't look like blue's got all these units there.
176 Halberdy already to come out. Gee whiz. Go. Red thinking, come on. I don't trust you. You've said it. I don't trust you. You hurry up and take him out. I ain't got the resources or the military to do it. It was a good battle between Red and Grey though. Unless you all just over. Oh no, he went for it. Buff, buff, buff. Grey hasn't even changed his stance with Blue yet and he's already attacking him. Now he has. Get him! They're getting involved too. Oh, they're going off. I mean, it really is poor Duck, yeah, too right down there. I do not like how he played us. Oh, Grey's trying to pull to Red. I think we team him. Now that you just had most of your shit wiped out. And they're all there in front of your base. And you've got no gold. Probably got more gold in my pocket. I've got about 27 pence in there. Uh-oh, this just isn't going well for Grey now, is it? Bless, I mean, it was working. Okay, so the Blue decided to team with was going to win that fight. The only question now is, can Blue get into Red's base? I think he can. Give it some go, I think he can. And can Red produce enough units to defend against Blue and then go for his king himself? You know, but first we're going for Grey. Grey's king. No, it's not very defended. As soon as that happens, you've got a free run to the king and it's kind of slightly obvious where the king is. Because none of these have got flags on them. I'm saying, see if you've got a flag in here, flag in here, you know what I mean? Your kings, they're all going to be going for these first, but none of that matters now because Blue's going to set treason. Duck sent 3,000 food to Dr. Panda. What? Why? There's 33,000 food. Is that really? It's because he knows Blue played him. He's hating on Blue. Uh-oh. I'm not surprised the Blue played it there. Uh-oh. Did I know he's there? Oh, he's gonna hide behind the bush. Ah, brilliant. Did I know he's there? I'm not sure they do, to be honest. Oh, yep, they do. They definitely do know he's there. And it looks like, once again, Blue is about to play with the emotions of someone in our game. Which I'm all for. I'm all for that. Look, this is what's joked about Blue. He knows where the king is, because he's walling him in. He's also defending. Well, not defending, but yeah, there you go. Got your track, Grey. Uh-oh. Yeah, he's still just destroying the back. He's just literally tearing the soul out of people's villages. Look at this. Pillage everything. Leave nothing. The only thing your king has got is his cloak. I won't be surprised if Green takes the crown before he kills him as well. Blue, sorry.
could have killed the king. He could have killed him as soon as he knew he was there, but no. Red's research reason.
So Red now knows where the kings are, that king, and Grey's killed himself. Duck Duck's king died in mysterious circumstances. He killed himself. He weren't having that. He ain't playing with my life, you little punk, says Grey. Grey's thinking, no, if I'm going, I'm going on my own merit. Or someone probably popped out of the forest and killed him. Who knows? Either way, great game, Grey. Great game. Just unfortunately, the Hoth not so nice with him. This is like a Star Wars episode 3 now. It says Diplo, Dynamite, Techno God Lord, Emperor Elon Musk. Brilliant. It is. It is like that. So now what? Do we zoom out and see the Death Star? I don't even know if that is in Star Wars 3 or even if that is a Star Wars thing, so I've got to apologise if it's not. I'm sorry. I'm sure it is. I'm sure it doesn't matter though. Anyway, let's back to it. What's going on now then? Oh, we've got a stalemate. We've got blue on the left. We've got red on the right. Two players that have been top or close to the top of the leaderboard all game. Two players that have taken out kings. Most of the kings actually have been taken out by these pair. Two players that are very, very good. Blue's first game with us, like I said earlier, but he's clearly good at what he does. I know Dr. Panda's good at what he does. He's just sacrificed some lambs, I think. Something's happened. He wants more paladins, it's gotta be, isn't it? Yeah, of course it is. Who doesn't? So, says Red. To Grey. Wow. So nothing, Grey dead. So, says Red to Blue. That's a bit better. Yes. And it seems like Blue has been the decider for most of the game. Blue's got some stuff down here now. Oh, Blue is not stupid. He's got 154 military units. He's got a handful of them here. He's got a little knuckle full of them there. And he says, we do this the old-fashioned way. Or I jump out of... Yeah, I jump out and murder you, King. Oh my God, look at this. Look at this from Blue. He has got a fat load of units there ready and waiting. Oh, we build an arena, lock our king in, and see whose treb hits first. Brilliant. Do it. Lol. This is Red. 11 says Musk. I'm assuming that's the that's what they're going for. I mean, does Red trust him? Go, says Red. Does Red trust him? Because you pop your king out of here, and you pop your king out of there, and then you pop him out of here, and you pop him out of there. Yes. And now he's in this area, and then all of a sudden, bash, 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 bash. All these like jump out and shoot him dead, and it's all over. Oh, they've picked the arena. Green draft base. Blue starting it. I mean, it could all be a plan. Blue's under attack over here. Oh, Blue's just trying to take everyone out, that's why. Them Hoth not so nice is horrible. Absolutely horrible. Bless them luck. Oh, I think they might actually be doing this. Your army here, my army here. Oh,
yes.
They are probably going for this. They are going to do it. I think they're going to do it. I'm not sure about these. I just wouldn't trust it. If I was Red now, I'm not going to lie. I would be so paranoid of these. Like, you obviously can't see what's in them. But I'm pretty sure you can see there's flags on them. You don't just have... I mean, even if there's just one unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6, 7, 8, 9. There's potentially 9 units if there's only one in each. Uh-oh.
You've done it. And blue hasn't popped out. If red gets his king up here on the move, blue hasn't moved yet. Blue hasn't even. His king's still in bed. Someone wake fat boy up, please. He's buying gold still, so red's still not 100% trusting. Red's thinking, I'm gonna get my gold just in case. No, sorry, stone. Oh, he's bought stone. One trip, says blue. Going for a one trip fight. Oh, this is actually going to happen. Red's king's got through. He's getting through. He's still in orb with yellow. That's good. Blue's king still in bed. Has someone not got blue king up yet? Come on. Gotta die. I mean, it's a good way to wake up in the morning, isn't it? Rise and shine, your highness.
What's on the agenda today?
You're gonna have to go and stand in some sort of fortified gated wall and just wait for a big trebuchet to sling a huge effing rock at you. I hope it don't hit you on the head.
No.
No. Your highness, come on. Get up. You got no choice.
Who says who?
Diplo Dynamite, Techno God, Lord Emperor Elon Musk.
Okay. One shall get this house out of the bed.
I wonder if it's a queen size bed. Wow, they really are going for it here. My trebuchet set, so it is. Ooh. Now, red's got their king out, just here. Bird watching. Deer watching, maybe. I will move my king. When Palisade's done, I'll move my king. I'm still not 100% trusting Blimey here. I'm really not. What is going to happen? It's like, alright then, well, let me sort that out. Blue's taking this extremely seriously, which is brilliant. Blue's king gone. There he is. Now, do we want to see this arena war of kings and treb? Or will it be absolutely hilarious to see someone's king go to run in the middle and someone's army take out that king really quick? Because that would be a big shock to the system. Blue, alright. Oh, we're getting close. I can sense it. I have villagers to sacrifice in honor of the game. Love it. Five villagers to sacrifice in honor of the game. Love it. That's exactly what we deserve. We deserve sacrificial lambs. I'll get my monk to officiate. Brilliant. Bring him in. King's just chilling. Everyone's chilling. Trebs are set. Sacrificial lambs are ready. Monk is on his way. Somewhere. They're still going to that's a big bombard tower. Okay. Dummy 11. Dummy's still here watching. Dummy, you're a legend. Legend. Loving him. People are still here watching. It's good to watch anyway. He's good. Kings are still where the kings were. No movement as of yet. What we were waiting for then, guys? Because people are still building up here. What are we building? What are we waiting for? Other than Bishop. Not Bishop. What are they called? Monk. Sorry. Here ya, says Blue. Wait, there's Red. Oh. Brilliant. The first annual Treb Shot game shall soon commence. From 9 to 11. Perfect.
more sacrificial lambs. Oh, it's eerie. It's quiet. After everything, after such a great game, lots of backstabbing, lots of sacrificial lambs, lots of chat, lots of people getting murdered. It all comes down to this. One arena. Two trips. Two kings. Now we'll just wait and watch the honorary sacrifice. As is tradition, the sacrificial five lambs in the form of villagers. Blue King enters the arena. Oh, bum 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 bum. Their soul might go to heaven, says Red.
See?
Yes, they may. Yes, they may. They will rest in the tomb of gods. Who else have we got here? Oh, Red. Red's king is in the chamber. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Gates are locked. All the gates have been locked. That's it now. That is it. Blue shakes Red King's hand. Very, very, very nice of you, Blue. There was the sacrifice from Blue, as is tradition. Now Red. Red's sacrificial lambs, per tradition. Brilliant. The monks leave the area. Token of all the blood spilled this game. I mean, that is just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Couldn't have asked for a better tribute. There's a great show put on by these two. Diplo Dynamite, Techno God, Lord Emperor Elon Musk, and Dr. Panda. Blue
food
and Red.
Please.
2 hours,
food, please.
28 minutes and 30 seconds.
No.
For all. Two, one, put your money on. Last orders at the bar. Who have we got? War declared. Trebuchet is launched. Red moves. Wow.
Finished replaying game.
Oh, wow. What a game. What a game. Guys, I got to say, absolutely brilliant. Brilliant to watch. Brilliant to cast. Brilliant to try and voice over. I hope I've done it enough justice, because I'm 100% sure that's so much more funny stuff, backstabbing, danger and death was going on behind the scenes where we weren't watching, and it's my vlog, so that's my first one. So I tried to capture as much as I can. I tried to give it some context and to speak about the units, and I might be terrible at it, but I enjoyed it. I enjoyed that a lot, so I cannot wait for the next one. I really can't. Big shout out to first to Green Giraffe for setting up the lobby and getting all that done. Top member in the server, so brilliant, thank you to you. Another big shout out to Old Crook Woody, Duck Duck, Petrolhead, Pacific Nick West, Dommy, Green Giraffe, Dr. Panda, and also the winner of the first casted C4's Diplo game, Techno God, Lord Emperor, Elon Musk, aka Diplo Dynamite. Absolutely brilliant game by you. Brilliant game by everyone. Bar a few decisions from some people, but that's Diplo for you.